up guys, my name is The Technical Hour here and welcome to the Daily Tech. Without further delay, let's get started. The first one we have here is the most exciting one. It is about the ROG 3 leaks. ROG just appeared on its Stena certification where we saw a few images of it. From the initial leaks and images, it looks very impressive. The design is going to be similar to its predecessor, but we are going to see an additional lens here. However, it is going to sport a 6.59 inch Full HD Plus OLED panel. This would be clocked at 144 Hz refresh rate. This is really exciting. Also, it is going to have an overclocked version of Snapdragon 865, that is Snapdragon 865 Plus. With a 5800 mAh battery, this thing is going to be thick at 9.85 mm. 865 means it is going to be 5G capable. With specs as high as 16GB of RAM and 1TB of storage, this is going to be the specking again. Another leak suggested that it has smashed a whooping 646,000 on Antutu. Now these numbers can be varied, but it is pretty much possible for ROG to score the highest. We have seen that happening in past 2 years. Other interesting features would be the LDDR5 RAM and UFS 3.0 storage. It is supposed to be coming out in July, and personally, I am very much excited about this release. So let's wait for it. Samsung is preparing for its big launch event. It will be also having the Samsung Galaxy Z Flip 5G. We saw the normal Z Flip earlier this year, but they are going to upgrade the processor from 855 Plus to 865, and hence it will be a 5G certified phone. It is supposedly coming with a 8GB of RAM and at least 256GB of storage. With a 15W fast charging, it will be a very fancy device to own. Now this Samsung event is going to be big because we are going to see the Note 20 unveiling, the Samsung Galaxy Watch 3 unveiling, the Samsung Galaxy Buds and the Samsung Galaxy Tab S7. We recently talked about the Tab S7. A leak suggests that S7 Plus might also be coming and it will be having a larger 12.4 inch display. It is supposedly going to have 120 Hz refresh rate and that is going to be eye-catching feature here. Also with a 9800 mAh battery, it is just going to last forever. Besides this, under the hood, it is supposedly going to have a Snapdragon 865 and at least 6GB of RAM. So let's see when it comes out and at what price. Samsung has also announced that Samsung Galaxy A71 5G in US. Before this, the cheapest 5G phone available in US was the OnePlus 8. Globally, the A71 is powered with the Exynos 980 CPU, but specifically in US, it will be launched with a 765G. It comes with a 6.7 inch Super AMOLED display and a big 4500 mAh battery. Now speaking of 765G, LG is also set to release its mid-range flagship, but at a premium price. The LG Velvet is all set to launch with Snapdragon 765G, but it is going to be a premium price, which is $800. But let's see, we'll be keeping an eye on it. HTC is also all set to join the mid-range game with its HTC U20 5G. This thing will be having a 6.8 inch Full HD Plus AMOLED panel with a punch hole camera cutout. Apart from that, it will be having a quad camera setup in the back and a humongous 5000 mAh battery. Under the hood, it will be having Snapdragon 765G and 8GB of RAM and 256GB of storage. The offering sounds pretty sweet. Let's look at the price when it comes out. The HTC's Desire 20 Pro will also be coming and it'll be having the exact same quad camera setup like the U20 5G. Apart from that, it'll be having a 6.5 inch Full HD Plus LCD panel with a punch hole cutout camera. It'll be coming with a slightly less power Snapdragon 865 coupled with 6GB of RAM and 128GB of storage. Let's keep a look on the pricing. Realme also teased the Realme X3 in an official video. Realme X series has been pretty good. We don't have any official announcement on the specs it is going to house. Earlier in 2019, we saw the launch of Pixel 3a and it was one of the most successful Pixel devices yet. By now, we know exactly how it is going to look and what are the specs it is going to house. It was supposedly going to be released in the first quarter of this year, but it did not happen. Then it got delayed to May, then to June, and now it is delayed to July. Well, that is it guys, that is it for today. I hope you liked the video. In case you did, then please show some love and support by hitting that like button and subscribe to the channel. Also share the video with your friends who are tech enthusiasts and help the channel grow. Thanks a lot for watching. I'll talk to you guys soon. Till then, stay at home and take care. Bye-bye.